All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We are the final game of day one here at the 2019 International Wftda Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, hosted by Greensboro Roller Derby. And it's going to be a great, great game as we have the number one seed, Texas Rollergirls, Tex-Executioners, going up against the Atlanta Roller Derby, Dirty South Derby Girls. My name is B. Armageddon.
I'm Julia Sleezer.
And we are going to be your vocal guides here on our WFTDA.tv stream. Thank you so much for tuning in. We're going to go ahead and I guess we'll talk about a little bit about how we got here. Of course, Texas being the number one seed. This is our first game of the weekend. Atlanta played a very, very great game early in the day against Bay Area and took the victory over Bay Area.
And everyone's brackets have been broke. If it didn't happen after the first game, it certainly happened after the second. There are two unbroken brackets right now, and
right.
They'll be on toast.
And if you hit those two, you are lucky. Here we go on our roster starting off Texas. They'd be wearing red. At number 050 is Bad Juju. 1010, Bazooka Bubble Bum. 14 is Cold Case. 163, Legal Knievel. 202 is Freight Train. 226 is Terabyte. 27 is Peace War. 300, Chris Rajo. 32 is Captain Sassy. 34, Bo Jackson. 420 is Stoneher. 55, Hoss the Boss. 69 is Dar Dar Binks. 82 is Marizy Livin. And number 9 is Nine Lives.
And for Atlanta Roller Derby, Dirty South Roller Derby, who will be playing in white with red accents. 101, Rosie Derivator. 1017, Gucci Mane. 12, Rebel Yellow. 128, Coco. 143, Baller Shot Collar. 1915, Ziploc. 1962, Human Missile Crisis. 21, Blackjack. 213, Afro Dyke. 23, Matitude Adjustment. 31, Erica Beduzzi. 33, Troublemaker. 39 for Hermione Danger. 6, Wild Cherry. And 76, Queen Luzitifa.
And of course, the winner of this game moves on tomorrow to face Dos Pocuatro, who won just the game prior to us, defeating Paris. That will be an 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time start for that one tomorrow. But we're going to talk about this game right here. And of course, we saw Atlanta earlier had a very, very strong performance against Bay Area. And of course, like I said, we haven't seen Texas yet this weekend. But a lot of these names on the roster have been here for a while, a lot of returning people. But it's the same thing with Atlanta. A lot of familiar people on this roster. So it should be a very, very exciting game. We're going to go ahead and introduce you to our officials who are going to be officiating this game officially. Starting off with our non-skating officials, that is Geo Knitter, Apron, Silken Tofu, Melody Mayhem, Ricochet, Neutron Scar, W.E.B. Destroys, Pat Sweeney, The Doctor, Coconut Chanel, and Wicked Widget.
And for our skating officials, it'll be Bass Invader, Pika, Will Ryder, Doesn't Matt Her, Recordian, Shotgun Mike, Jane Goodcall, and Technical Difficulty.
So we are about 50 seconds or so away from getting this game officially underway. It's been a very, very fun day so far, Julia.
It's been an amazing day so far. I'm really happy. I do have to point out the sun has the power of like 15 suns here. And every time I go outside, I die a little. But it's evening now. Yep.
I'm a southern boy. I'm used to this.
I left all this weather behind more than once now, and I forget that it's a thing that can happen. So tomorrow, I imagine I will be very sunburnt from walking for 2 minutes or whatever. But no, it's been an amazing day. This is an absolutely astounding venue. The hosts have been perfect. The teams are in really good spirits, and we've seen, you know, as you would expect, some of the top-level derby for this season.
Yeah, and we're going to get our marquee game of the day underway here. It looks like our first two jammers at the line will be number 202 Freight Train jamming for Texas against number 213 Afro Dyke for Atlanta. And off we go with jam number one. Whistle blows in the pack immediately, but lead jammer is going to go to Freight Train.
Freight Train already coming up to meet the pack for their first, or for her first scoring pass. The pack has not moved past the pivot line.
But Freight Train has a couple of times now. And a scoring pass, not picking up the first 4 points of the game. Pack, like you said, just getting to the pivot line now.
Yeah.
So Freight Train again approaching. And we have a star pass by Atlanta to, I believe, Blackjack, number 21. So Blackjack now taking over jammer obligations as the pack moving through turn one. Whistles blow. Jameis Call, looks like Texas gets another 4 points on the pass. So an 8-point jam starts us off in favor of the team in red. Texas, of course, wearing those special jerseys for tournament. I know they were selling some to the public earlier this year, I saw, but they're special edition jerseys for playoffs.
They're really rad. I really enjoy the font and everything. So we see a replay there of acquiring lead jammer as we get set up for the next jam just 5 seconds before. The penalty box is empty.
And here we go. That is number 55, Haas the Boss, jamming for Texas up against number 33, Troublemaker for Atlanta.
Another kind of thick start to the pack as both jammers trying to sweep their way through with no purchase as of yet.
And nice work up front by Texas. Oh, but nice blocking up front trying to free your jammer up, Erica Baduzzi. But Texas, once again, reforming very quickly to kind of shut Troublemaker down. And meanwhile, same thing in the back. Atlanta's brace two wall really holding up Haas the Boss.
I feel like they're really close to splitting up at this point, but they're keeping it ever so slightly, well, you know, legal.
We knew both of these teams coming in have very good defenses, so we knew this was going to be kind of one of the main points
of this game.
So, of course, they're showing that off right now early on as, again, the pack just now kind of still stuck in turn two. The Troublemaker trying to lean in on that Texas wall. Texas trying to bridge. Stonehur, I see in the middle there, trying to serve as a bridge, now getting up front to help block. And once again, nice blocking there by Ball of Shot Caller for Atlanta, trying to help free up Troublemaker, but again, Texas not letting her go.
Haas the Boss looked like she was going to try to make her way through, does get knocked into the inside and finds herself back held again as we are almost at turn three.
We're almost to a full rotation around the track.
We made it to the other straightaway.
We did. We're almost to turn three, maybe make a full rotation, but our jam's 30 seconds on the jam clock, so we might not make it the way we're going is defense. Now Haas the Boss up front, trying to get around Ball of Shot Caller.
Yeah, Ball of Shot Caller doing a great job of single-handedly holding her back. Now joined by teammate Queen Luz Yatifa. And that is going to be a jammer penalty. That is a cut called on Troublemaker.
So we do have a power jam for Texas. And Haas the Boss now makes it through. Finally earns lead jammer. A full minute and 55 seconds into the jam.
Wow.
We have a lead jammer. And the jam is now called for time. And looks like no points will be given to Haas the Boss. She did not make any scoring passes, so we're still at an 8-0 game.
Oof. Wow.
Defense.
You can see the replay there of
you can see
excellent
nice.
Blocking, trying to yep. Atlanta trying to break up Texas's defense.
Erica Baduzzi tried really hard to get strike out, but Texas just reformed very quickly and got back in front. Now here we go, next jam, number 1010. That is Bazooka Bubble Bum jamming up against Troublemaker. And lead jammer gonna go to Bazooka Bubble Bum.
Ooh, oh. Thought she was gonna defend the back there. That was Blackjack losing her footing for just a moment.
And Bazooka Bubble Bum is one of the newer Texas skaters, been around for about a year or so. And just very, very impressive jammer to watch. I've seen her jam in a couple of different other capacities.
Sure.
But just a very, very impressive jammer to watch. And you've seen it right now. She is fighting up front with the Atlanta blockers, trying to break through. But meanwhile, Troublemaker now free from the penalty box and just working in the back. But all four of those Texas blockers just keying in on her. Meanwhile, Bazooka Bubble Bomb is through for 4 points.
In the meantime, Atlanta has lost Coco to the box. So they are down one blocker.
And it's like the star cover has come off for Troublemaker, trying to fight through the pack with star in hand. And one more time around, Bazooka Bubble Bomb picks up another four for Texas. Penalty box clears out.
I'm sorry. I was just going to say, right now an 8-point jam.
Right.
But yeah, right. More importantly. Yeah.
Troublemaker, of course, making now her initial pass, so now scoring eligible. And Bazooka Bubble Bomb calls it off, picks up a couple before calling it off.
That was three more points on that pass, making an 11-point jam total, so 19 points to Texas. Atlanta still has not managed to score a point, but we are early days. This was just the end of jam 3.
Oh, yeah, we still have a long way to go in this
game.
And another great jammer matchup, Freight Train, once again, 202 at the jam line for Texas. That is number 1962, Human Missile Crisis, jamming for Atlanta.
Penalty box once again empty as we start off, so.
And Freight Train trying to take an inside gap. Meanwhile, Missile Crisis trying to go through the middle of the pack. Kept her balance there, stays in bounds, but furious work in the pack. And there goes Freight Train. Who lead jammer for Texas.
Thought Ziploc was going to be able to hold her back there for a minute, but not the case. Freight Train coming in, as you might expect, like a freight train, does meet Atlanta's defense in the back, and they're doing an amazing job of holding it.
And meanwhile, Missile Crisis still working now, being swamped by the Texas defense, getting drawn back all the way to the pivot line by Stoneher.
So Human Missile Crisis does have the star in her hand. She does look like she's attempting to pass it to her pivots, and I...
Meanwhile, we saw a pirouetting freight train coming through the middle of turn two and picks up a full 4 points, and now an official pass has been made for Missile Crisis. Now both jammers eligible to score points.
I was literally stunned by the beauty of that move and lost my train of thought. And the star pass actually didn't happen. She took it off and put it back on. Yep. Oh, I thought that you said it did. Okay. Yeah. I wasn't trying to jump you, but I was like, it's the same person. It's the same person.
So it looks like a total of 7 points picked up by Freight Train on that jam. Texas now 26, Atlanta still scoreless. But you see the replay right here. Freight Train just trying to plow it through the block of Matitude Adjustment. And we're going to line up here and get going with our next jam. Looks like we have Gucci Mane for Atlanta wearing the star against Hoss the Boss for Texas.
It's going to be Gucci Mane taking lead for Atlanta. But it is the first time Atlanta has taken lead.
Yeah, Hoss the Boss, though, not far behind now as both jammers re-reach the pack. And the jam is called off. It looks like 1 point picked up by Hoss on the way up.
Plot twist. No.
27-0 at Texas with the advantage. We're about 22 minutes and change to go here in our first half, our last game of the day here on day one. We still have two more days to go. This is, of course, our second quarterfinal game. As we said, the winner will move on to face Dos Por Cuatro tomorrow. And away we go. That is number 32 for Texas, wearing the star, Captain Sassy, up against Aphrodite for Atlanta. Pack over in the turn 1-2 vicinity.
Ooh,
and Captain Sassy, getting knocked out of bounds. Big blocks up front there by Ziploc. I saw played one of those.
Ziploc is full of big blocks. Just absolutely amazing. Lead goes for the second time to Atlanta. That is Aphrodite taking lead and coming up on the pack, hoping to score points.
That pack's still stuck right outside of turn number two, but we have had a star pass completed by Texas, number 34. That is Bo Jackson taking over as the jammer. Has not put the cap on yet.
It's all good.
Yeah, meanwhile, Aphrodite still trying to work through the pack, sees the incoming Bo Jackson and calls off the jam. Looks like an additional 4 points for Atlanta, so that's their first 4 points of the game. So they are on the board, and look at the replay here. You see a big bump there, Ziploc.
Yeah.
Joined up front there by Baller Shot Caller.
Oof.
Almost kept their balance.
So close.
So here we go. Jammers lining up with the blockers. We have Freight Train jamming for Texas. Troublemaker wearing the star for Atlanta. And tight pack off the whistle. Freight Train again tries to duck to the inside. Takes a big bump from Blackjack.
Yow. I'm just full of noises. I'm sorry.
It's a lot of noises in Derby. Meanwhile, Freight Train picking up lead jammer and a penalty assessed to Blackjack. I'm sorry, just Queen Lujatifa, apologies. Meanwhile, Troublemaker is through for her initial. Jammer's call looks like Freight Train did get 4 points. So 31-4, Texas now with the lead. That last jam brought to you by our friends at Quick. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick bearings where precision meets performance. Sorry about that.
Sorry, we've got two ad reads and I didn't want him to write on tomorrow's. That was that.
We have to keep things fresh for tomorrow.
We just don't want to confuse people.
We have a team timeout called here by Atlanta, freezing the clock at 19 minutes and 57 seconds to go. And Julia, can we talk about another great sponsor?
We totally can. I was going to tell you about Derby Without Borders, which
is
a charity project dedicated to smashing the barriers of accessibility to roller derby around the world by providing leagues with coaching, support, and equipment. You can check out their organization and how you can get involved at derbywithoutborders.org.
Very, very indeed a worthwhile cause. Of course, in the venue here, we have a cool mural going on over there that people can sign for Derby Without Borders.
Ooh.
So if you know somebody that's here and they haven't seen it yet, which I can't imagine why, because it's a nice big thing over there in the corner, tell them to go sign it.
Or you know what? We've got 2 days left. Just bring yourself.
It's true. Yeah, you got time to get up here. Come on.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter where you are. You got time to get up here. So we're gonna
actually, I guess we're in the middle of a hurricane, so maybe.
No, it's a little. It's finally going away from here.
It's
thankfully.
Petered off.
Yeah, thankfully. And here we go back to action on the track. Hoff, the boss, Jamin for Texas against Magnitude Adjustment, wearing the star for the first time tonight for Atlanta.
Woo.
And Hoff, the boss, to the inside, picking up lead.
Magnitude still trying to bust through the pack. Texas defense is absolutely not letting that happen. She does take to the offensive as Haas the Boss re-enters to pick up points.
And returning Queen Lujatifa helping out with some of the blocking here for Atlanta in the middle of that pack. Now also joined by Erica Baduzzi as Haas the Boss, meanwhile, finding a hold to the inside, skates through for a scoring pass, 4 points.
Narrowly. It looked like she was going to get knocked into the inside at that last second, but made it through unscathed and is now re-entering for another scoring
and
pass.
Looks like we have a star pass by Atlanta. Passed over to Ball of Shot caller. And nice work in the back block in there. Magnitude Adjustment just laying the hip into Haas.
Yeah, fair enough.
And that actually allowed Baller to get around, but unable to score any points. Texas did get a couple.
I feel a little bit like, you know, when we saw Magnitude go on the offense as a jammer, and then she passed the star and was like, nah, I'm blocking now.
And I am going to block. That's what I did.
Yeah.
And here we go. New jammer for Texas at the line, number 69, Dar Dar Binks. Wearing the star up against Human Missile Crisis for Atlanta. Dardar, one of the newer Texas skaters this season.
Yeah. I would not have known if you did not tell me, because she's been doing an amazing job.
Yes.
So.
And still, once again, these tight packs doing work, barely past the pivot line.
Crisis nearly through, does get knocked into the inside. Looks like she is going to end up recycling all the way back behind Texas's three wall.
And Dardar also having a tough time with that Atlanta defense, too. That braced wall in the front, Blackjack doing a great job as a brace. But
what?
Dardar trying to do a handstand maybe to get around, but not quite. And then Blackjack there to meet her and send her backwards.
Oh, my gosh. There's a lot going on there. And oh, it's going to land a penalty, it looks like. I did not see, but we'll try to.
And that is going to mean a power jam for Atlanta. And the star has been passed by Atlanta, the Blackjack. The track cut was that call on Dardar. Meanwhile, as we said, star pass completed. Blackjack now the jammer for Atlanta.
What? What did she add it on? She took it off.
It didn't quite fit right. She had to
adjust. Oh, okay. I was like, what's happening?
And the direction of gameplay penalty picked up by Stoneher. And Blackjack, meanwhile, to the outside, finds a wide open lane, makes the scoring pass, 4 points for Atlanta.
But that is, you know, Atlanta hasn't scored but 4 points prior in this game, so those 4 points are very important, of course.
Dardar back into play for Texas, able to squirt through the middle of the pack to make her initial. Penalty assessed to Peace War for Texas. Meanwhile, another 4 points picked up by Blackjack.
Dardar about to come into scoring position with a very much depleted pack, as the penalty box has been very popular in this jam.
And looks like a couple of points picked up by Texas on the pass and a total jam. 8 points for Atlanta, though, 39-12. The score in favor of the top-seeded Texecutioners.
The S1 Lifer helmet is best fit plus superior protection, which equals made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. Check them out at s1helmets.com.
Just watching the replay there. Lots of blocking going on in the middle there on Dardar, that last jam. Here we go. Current jam. Looks like we have Freight Train once again wearing the star for Texas. That is Gucci Mane with the star for Atlanta.
Got this very thick start, but while they're distracted with the inside, Gucci Mane is going to take the outside, getting lead jammer status in the meantime. Freight Train still trying to work her way through.
And Gucci Mane getting knocked to the inside. Being bumped out by Chris Rajo. Going to reset, try it again.
Freight Train has removed the star, but not sure if she intends to pass it or just needs a break from the pressure.
Oh,
but she is going to go to
penalty,
the penalty
box. A back block call on Freight Train. So once again, a power jam for Atlanta. Gucci Mane, of course, also lead jammer as well, now leaning on that front Texas defense, trying to edge around the block of Peace War. And now getting some help from some of her blockers rushing up to break up the Texas wall party up front. The blocking wall is trying to reform. Meanwhile, oh, we're coming into turn number three now. Once again, Texas trying to get the defense set up. And oh, nice work up front, nice clear out block there. A ball of shot caller trying to open it up for Gucci Mane. Gucci Mane again now once again tied up behind the Texas defense.
The blockers that might want to help her are distracted in the back, as
they're a little busy with Freight Train.
With Freight Train, I understand.
That is understandable and acceptable.
She does have a friend up front helping her out, and that is Bali Shotkali.
And meanwhile, Gucci Mane just looking, trying to get some kind of guidance of where to go. And this time trying to get some additional help there from Erica Baduzzi. And it's like a star pass has been completed by Texas to Peace War. And jam will be called. Looks like Atlanta got to come away with 4 points. And the only 4 points of the jam, as we now have a 39-16 lead in favor of Texas.
So we are eking that score up a bit closer to Texas's. And we got that replay going.
And to Gucci Mim in the middle there, just getting surrounded by a bunch of Texas. And Peace War just laid into her right there. Peace War indeed a heavy hitter when it comes to blocking, and you see right there why. And we're lining up now for jam number 11. Off we go. Aphrodite is a jammer for Atlanta. Hawks, the boss, counters for Texas. And Aphrodite threw on the outside in turn one to pick up lead.
Pack again, still behind the pivot line as she comes in for a first scoring pass. And Haas, the boss, did make it out, having completed her initials. So before she can get into scoring position, though, Aphrodite does call it off.
Yep, gets the 4 points, calls it off, and now closes a little bit closer now. A 19-point differential, 39-20. Right about 13 minutes left in the first half. So Atlanta starting to kind of edge away at these 4-0 jams. I mean, you keep Texas off the board. If you can get something, at least you're going to close that gap up. Next jam lining up here looks like Bazooka Bubble Bum once again jamming for Texas. That is Troublemaker for Atlanta. And once, like I said, we said earlier on, defense is going to be a story in this game, and it really has been. Both of these teams have put on very, 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 very strong wall work.
But the different styles of defense is, because I keep going like, oh, this is like much earlier in the game, but only, you know, this many minutes has elapsed.
Yeah.
So like the defense we see in every jam has been so varied. This is reminiscent of jam two.
Exactly.
Just 20 minutes before, you know. It's been absolutely beautiful to watch.
Now we have up front, looks like Bazooka Bubble Bum is working on Bala Shot. Look at Bala digging in with those toe stops, trying to stop Bazooka Bubble Bum. Trying to stretch her out, and there she goes. Lee Jammer does go to Texas.
Absolutely amazing.
And looks like a star pass has been completed by Atlanta to Bala Shot Caller. And now Bazooka Bubble Bum trying to get around in front, runs in the Queen Lujativa, says, no, we're going to stop right here. But not before Bala got through and got 3 points.
Texas did pick up two. That puts us 41-23 as we approach the 10 minutes mark.
That's that ever important, do not give up on a jam until that final whistle blast, because
absolutely,
that was a great job by Bala Shot Caller to get in and sneak in and take those 3 points at the very end. And off we go, Freight Train once again wearing the star for Texas. Human Missile Crisis, the Atlanta jammer. And Freight Train through on the outside for lead.
Nicely done. In the meantime, Crisis is being recycled back and is going to meet up with a Texas three-wall. Freight Train took to the outside. Did not quite work out. Trying it one more time. Narrowly avoids Queen Lusgatifa. Atlanta had gotten out, having completed the initial. Not enough time to score points.
Yep, so Texas comes away with a 4-0 jam victory, 45-23. Experience world-class edging with the number one wheel in Derby, Radar Halo. Check out our friends at Radar Wheels, part of the Rydell family. Lining up for jam number 14. And away we go. Gucci Mame is the Atlanta jammer. She is accounted by Hoss the Boss for Texas. And again, just a mess of blocking going on right before the pivot line, Julia.
I was like, I barely see Ziploc. But I know she's doing what Ziploc does.
And she actually did pick up a penalty in the contact there. Did Ziploc. So we're going to have one blocker down for Atlanta.
Absolutely leaning full force on this tripod in the back, but to no avail.
But similar action in the front, though. We're finally able to break through and pick up lead. Hoss the Boss finds a way around.
Hoss nice, coming in now, does meet up halfway through the pack with Atlanta.
Nice job on the drawback by Stoneher. So Gucci Mame going to start back from behind the jam line. Also now a recycle by Hoss the Boss. Penalty picked up by Ball Shot Caller. Meanwhile, Hoss is through for a scoring pass. 4 points. And again, like these blockers, I feel like they don't get to see the track very much. Or they only get to see like turn one. They don't get to go very far. And another pass by Hoss and another 4 points for Texas. But Gucci Mame still took with the cap off, still trying to work through that Texas defense. Now finally able to go through on the inside. A multiplayer block going to be called on the contact up front. That is against Marisi Livin. Yes. A star pass by Atlanta. That is Matitude adjustment now as the jammer. Jammer's call. Looks like three more points rung up for Texas. Eight as a 11-point jam in total. There we go. 56-23 in favor of Texas. Yeah, we've been talking about, like I said, the defense has been so tight. Like I said, in this first half, you know, skaters still have all the energy. And like, look at that, right
that
there.
Woo,
big bump out there by Ball. And she's like, what did I do?
What did I do?
What did I do? All right, off we go. Aphrodite jamming for Atlanta. And that is Captain Sassy again wearing the star for Texas. A track cut can be called on Texas. Meanwhile, we have a lead jammer. It is Aphrodite.
They are approaching ever so slowly the first apex.
Now, here we go. Aphrodite through, gets the scoring pass for four. And we've seen Atlanta do this. Do they keep going and try to rack up points on the jam, or do they just try to call it and chip away?
Well, the opposing jammer is still trying to complete her initial. Right. I would assume you'd want to, you know, do that. But, like, there has been a star pass on behalf of Texas, which has gone to Peace War. Yep.
And looks like Aphrodite will call off the jam. She does get 3 points.
Seemed like a reasonable time.
So 7-point jam in total. Now going to cut a little more into that lead, 56-30. Only 26 points separating these two teams. And there's a replay. See Aphrodite, they're edging around the outside. Wow. We've talked about it in previous games. Aphrodite's speed is just incredible.
Amazing. Freight train out once again for Texas. Troublemaker for Atlanta, and it very quickly is going to go. Lead being awarded to Troublemaker.
Troublemaker found that inside gap and just kind of ran right through it.
Sure.
And picked up lead jammer.
You see a lane, take it.
Yeah, exactly. A freight train trying to take an outside lane here for her initial, and she does. Meanwhile, Troublemaker still trying to now get points on the board, getting just find a bob and weave through the pack, takes a big hit up front, and right back up on her wheels. Meanwhile, freight train takes advantage of the confusion through on the outside for 4 points.
Pack missed the pivot line and decided to come on back to it just as the jam is called.
So a 4-4 jam, so split the difference, but it's the same differential, just a few more points higher and a little more time off the clock.
Have you tried the Adam Savant wheels?
I haven't because I'm not a skater, but I'm sure they're awesome. So tell me about them, please.
The rest of it was see what you've been missing.
Well, I mean, I'm missing
it. I feel like you thought I knew more than I did, I'm afraid.
Well, they are awesome wheels, I know. So here we go, our next jam. Hoss the Boss wearing the star for Texas. Human Missile Crisis is the Atlanta jammer. And it looks like a penalty picked up by Peace War. So the pivot for Texas in the penalty box. And once again, a scrum pack at the pivot line. And Human Missile Crisis spinning outside, able to fight through and earn lead.
So this pack still swarming around now just at the jammer line does do a very strange block to Crisis as she came in on her first scoring pass. She seems a bit dizzy from it.
Still reeling a little bit from the contact.
Yeah.
That in the four is actually, I think, pretty slick too from what we're being told, but the skaters seem to love it. Penalty picked up by Blackjack, so now the Atlanta pivot spending time in the penalty box. And here Mr. Crisis is going to go ahead and call it off to seeing Haas coming up in turn three. 3 points picked up for Atlanta. So now 37 for Atlanta, 60 for Texas, 4.5 minutes until halftime.
Wow. I feel like this game has really, like, soared by, but like I said earlier, it also feels like it's there's been so much amazing and varied gameplay on.
All right, lining up by jam number 18. And that is going to be Dardar Binks again jamming for Texas. Gucci Mame jamming for Atlanta. And Dardar trying to go outside, but denied by Balashaw Caller.
Yeah, I'm absolutely not interested.
Very well, up front, trying to get it through, but they're knocked out of bounds. Is Gucci Mane going to recycle all the way back to the jam line almost? But through and lead. Ooh, sorry, there goes Dardar.
Yeah, there's a lot going on.
There's a lot going on. There's always a lot going on in Derby.
No, I'm just like, we both started.
Because we just saw something going on so awesome, right. We both had to talk about it, right?
Extra good things.
Penalty, I believe, assessed to Blackjack against her in the penalty box for a second time in this jam.
Dardar Binks finally making it through this lap. This passed through the pack and has picked up all four of the available points.
Another penalty for Atlanta. This time, attitude adjustment. So, been a kind of a rotating door for some of the blockers for Atlanta this jam, but another four picked up by Dardar. So taking advantage of that blocker advantage.
Absolutely.
And coming now in for, inside.
Yeah, that was absolutely taking advantage of that. Just like, whoop, right through the pack. That is another 4 points right now. A 12-point jam and one of the higher scoring jams, perhaps the highest for Texas.
And Blackjack so came back in and immediately took the star and unable to do anything about it. Another three for Texas, so a big jam for Dardar Binks.
Absolutely.
15-point jam gives Texas now 75, Atlanta 37. Is our replay? You can see Dardar, takes a big hit block right there and able to keep in bounds. Ooh, that was a strong block there by Wild Cherry. And we're now almost at about 2 minutes to go, so last few jams coming up. Aphrodite jamming for Atlanta, Freight Train jamming for Texas.
And it's going to be Freight Train taking lead. Aphrodite back in the pack now. She is also through, having completed her initial. In the meantime, Freight Train is already in scoring position.
And going to have to call it off there as Aphrodite was coming up hot. So looking to see if Texas got any points on that. I think they're going to confer and decide it. 1 point picked
all
up
right
by Texas.
On that. So 76 to 37. We are under 2 minutes left in this half. So this is either the ultimate or penultimate jam before we take a little break.
And it looks like we're going to have Haas the Boss jamming again for Texas, Troublemaker jamming again for Atlanta. Both of these two key jammers in their respective rotations and now meeting up with yet again another tight scrum pack at the pivot line.
Both jammers seem to be trying to take the inside line. Doesn't work for either of them.
It's like Troublemaker not trying to go outside that time, but again denied. Because once again, everybody is hanging out in the same spot, pretty much. Except now Troublemaker going to get recycled behind Stoneher and Bo Jackson. Yeah, again, it's a party in turn one all night long. We are barely getting out of turn one here. Whistles blow in the pack. Penalty assessed to Atlanta. Oh, and Blackjack taking a spill. And a Haas the Boss finally able to fight through that pack and pick up lead jammer.
Impact still at the top of the Apex there. And
like Troublemaker took off the star cap trying to fight through, but meanwhile, Hossam,
I'm going to go low.
Now that star has been passed to Blackjack. Let's see if Texas has any interest in letting her score some points. Oh, let's see. Did she make?
No.
I thought perhaps wine before that fourth whistle had happened, but it's not what happened. And so I believe, was it timeout? Oh, an official review has been called by Atlanta. So that is going to
freeze the clock at zero.
I'm not sure if we're going to have another GM. I think there may have been like 1 second on the clock because I saw it go to half and then it was like,
Nyeh. Yeah, so as of right now, it stands the clock at zero. So regardless of the review result, we will likely not have another jam, but you never know.
So we're gonna. I
never know anything, really. I mean, honestly.
I thought I did.
I just talk. But we're going to have a discussion.
You know what I do know about.
What do you know about?
You can follow along with live game updates and matchups at stats.wftda.com.
Yes, you can.
You can forecast the game results, keep up with who's playing who and when, and see how the playoffs affect live rankings. Check them out at stats.wftda.com. And speaking of which, if you haven't already busted your bracket.
mine's gone.
Yeah, I constantly forget to fill them out myself. But you can still play the bracket challenge, which is at derbyontoast.com. You enter your bracket predictions for the WFTDA Continental Cup, International Playoffs in Seattle, and, of course, championships. Prove your derby know-how, predict results, and you could win the last pair of VIP tickets for you and a friend to watch champs in person in Montreal. And a WFTDA.tv full postseason bundle. So visit them at derbyontoast.com and make your predictions. But all predictions must start and before the start of the tournament.
And so it's like they can't do it right now. We're going to have a discussion. Our head referee, Mason Vader, are going to talk to our captains and coaches and let them know. Then we will find out what their review was about.
Oh, no. Did I call him Bassin Vader earlier?
I think so.
Oh, no. Not
so
the fish.
So the teams are going to line up as if they feel like we're going to get another jam out of this. So, which, I mean, I'm not going to argue about
it. Well, that's what I was saying. I'm pretty sure there was, like, literally a second left on the clock because I saw it tick down. We went to as if we were going to do halftime.
After verifying that there was still time left on the period clock, Atlanta has been granted their official review, and they have elected to use it as a 60-second timeout.
Aha, you are
Review will not be retained.
Yes, thank you very much, Base Invader. So it was strictly a timeout, and we will get one more jam out of this half.
And I'm just, you know, say stuff because I like my voice, but I do.
You do know things.
Yeah, sometimes. Like, I knew that. I know some pretty basic math. And
what I know right now is we have Bazooka Bubble Bum jamming against Mattitude Adjustment. True facts. Hashtag truth. And everybody, again, what I know is we like turn one in this game a lot.
Yeah, love it. Love it. They're like, let's go hang out on the Apex. That sounds cool.
Mattitude Adjustment getting stuck in the back behind the Texas defense. Trying to work through the inside now. Oh, almost through.
Almost.
Not quite.
Having to recycle back. Penalty has been called.
Looking for a
whom?
Looks like a ball of shot caller for Atlanta.
All right. Everybody stopped like me.
Meanwhile, Bazooka Bubble Bum leaning up in the front, just trying to get around Erica Baduzzi, the last line of defense for Atlanta right here. Just pushing and pushing.
Word. That was all I had. I am shocked.
And finally gets through. We have a lead jammer. It is Bazooka Bubble Bum. And the pack is now moving toward turn number two. And Bazooka Bubble Bum back into the fray. And Star looks like has been passed by Atlanta to Blackjack. Oh, big hit on the way out there.
Yeah, for real.
Ball of shot caller. But 4 points were picked up by Bazooka Bubble Bum. Jam is called. And now we apparently have a halftime score. Or do we? I see a coach walking to the referee. So let's not say anything definite yet.
No, I feel pretty good that we're going to go to half.
I believe so. But
let's check out this replay regardless of this amazing hit.
Nice block out there. It's like Peace War.
Mm-hmm.
So looks like we are officially at halftime. There's our whistle.
All right. So we will be going into half with Texas at 87, Atlanta at 37. So a 50-point differential. It's math we can all do.
Yeah, it is. Pretty easy math. So, yeah, like we said, very defensive game by both teams. You know, a lot of different types of defense being thrown around there in the first half. Texas able to get some scoring early to kind of get a little bit up in the half. And we will see if Atlanta makes some adjustments at halftime and see what they can do in the second half.
Absolutely. So we will be back in about 12 minutes.
We'll see you in a few. All right. Welcome back. We are back here for our second half of our final game here, day one of the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. We, of course, come back to a big halftime score, 87-37 in favor of Texas.
Yeah, it's been an absolutely amazing game, and we've got the 50-point spread, as you pointed out. And in our first half, if you need a review or you're just joining us, I should point out that Texas got lead 14 times and Atlanta only 7. And the highest scoring jam was 15 points by Dardar in jam 18. So a lot of what we saw in the first half, as we mentioned, has been variances in defense. And I'm interested to see, because, like, you know, earlier games and in many games, we all see adjustments specifically to the opposition's gameplay. So I'm interested to see how both of these teams take this second half. And
sorry about that.
Sorry. The cameraman is talking over my headset. It's really confusing me. awkward pause. What was I saying? I'm excited to see how the second half goes.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry. I suddenly thought I had done something.
So here we're going to get our skaters and our officials back out in place, get our first jam underway. Terrell, it looks like we have a very good jammer matchup to start us off here. Looks like it'll be Afro Dyke for Atlanta, number 213 in the white. And against Freight Train, number 202 for Texas, in the red.
Absolutely, two jammers that were really nailing it in the first half, and I imagine in their entire careers.
I'm pretty sure.
Well-known names.
Yes.
So if you're just joining us, Texas is appearing in red, and Atlanta is in white.
And again, this is Texas' first game of the weekend. They're the number one seed coming in this weekend. Atlanta played earlier, defeated Bay Area to reach this game. And off we go for our first jam of the second half. And looks like we have a lead jammer, and that is Freight Train.
Absolutely. Really working to press through that pack, but does make it.
Aphrodite through for her initial.
Freight Train going to go ahead and call that off. She did pick up 1 point, bringing Texas up to 88, Atlanta at 37.
We get off to a big one-point jam start here, but
hey,
let's start. Hey, it's 1 point more than we had.
Didn't see you scoring any points.
Nah, exactly. I can say I've never scored a point in Derby in my life.
I think people only had me jam when they were annoyed with me.
Don't say that. Here we go. Human Missile Crisis is the Atlanta jammer. Hoss the boss for Texas, and Human Missile Crisis is through for lead for Atlanta.
Crisis. You can see, they see Crisis coming in. Texas tries to reform, doesn't quite make it, leaves that outside open, and 4 full points available.
Looks like Texas has passed the star to number 34, Bo Jackson. And Crisis emphatically calling off the jam, but does get 3 points. A 7 point total jam there for Atlanta.
Absolutely. It's 88-44. We have a divisible score.
We do. And looks like our next jammers up will be Troublemaker for Atlanta up against Bazooka Bubble Bum for Texas. All blockers and jammers on the track as we start jam at number 3. And once again, that defense just locks down right away both jammers.
And we've got, you know, a pretty scrummy game overall. Not a lot of, you know, laps.
No, not a fast-paced game by any means.
Well,
but
it's
okay.
It's fast, and it's like a microcosm on the track. So
But to them out there, it's very fast.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, exactly.
Inside that bubble,
right.
It is a lot of fast-paced stuff.
Speaking of bubble, bazooka bubble bum, picking up lead jammer for Texas.
Meeting up with Atlanta's defense is, again, just getting hung up there.
Atlanta track cut, going to be called on Troublemaker. It's a penalty box trip for her. Power jam for Texas. Bazooka Bubble Bum working the outside, able to scoot through, and does complete the scoring pass for four.
Bench absolutely yelling, call it, call it, call it. She does hear it. I thought she was going to go on by and continue.
So, of course, that means we will have a power start coming up our next jam in favor of Texas.
The all-new Antic Jet Carbon is packed with features at a great price. Antic Jet Carbon Featherweight Performance.
And our power start will be Captain Sassy jamming for Texas.
Everybody moving back to guard that jammer line.
And Sassy looking to get through in the inside. Now going into the middle. And yeah, nicely done through there, lead jammer.
Nobody managed to close it up. But back in play is Troublemaker. Fresh out of the box and immediately through the pack.
And Miwa Jam will be called off. Looks like 2 points picked up additionally for Texas. Going to give it now back to that 94-44 differential. To the replay. Nice turnaround there. Backward skating to make it through on that lap for Lee Jammer. And stop me if you've seen this one before. Freight Train versus Aphrodite. In a rematch of these two awesome jammers.
Aphrodite trying to make way through the middle is going to find herself right in the middle of a tripod up front.
And trying to edge on the inside is Aphrodite. Meanwhile, Freight Train still mired in the back of the pack. And there goes Aphrodite, lead jammer.
Efforts do pay off.
And that is what Atlanta needs right now, is to get those lead jammer statuses and use that to their advantage. And Aphrodite trying to do just that is now meeting up again with the Texas defense.
Freight Train moving the pack along with their own blocking.
But Atlanta has done very well in this game of kind of stifling Freight Train.
Absolutely. And but
we have a star pass now for Texas.
So it's going to be legal Knievel.
And unable to capitalize. Jam is called. 3 points picked up additionally on that pass for Aphrodite. Here's our replay here. You can see Aphrodite dodging to the inside.
I think she realized that they'd rotated ever so slightly and she could disengage and come out.
We set up for our jam number 6 of our second half. Looks like it's going to be Wftda Boss for Texas, jamming against Human Missile Crisis for Atlanta.
So Crisis managing to start in the middle, but take to the outside, does get lead jammer status for Atlanta.
And meanwhile, Haas still stuck in the front wall set up there by Atlanta. Crisis now, of course, on a scoring pass. Again, these defenses, once again, trying to lock down tight on these jammers.
Getting knocked out to the outside and recycling back. That is Crisis still trying to get through on this scoring pass.
And it tangled up in the middle in turn number 2, but through the pack, picking up points. Human Missile Crisis for 4. Oh, looks like a penalty has been assessed to Wftda Boss. Looks like a low block was the call, so we're going to have a power jam for Atlanta. And that could be just what the doctor ordered as Human Missile Crisis spinning through that pack picks up the 4 points.
He's got plenty of time to continue scoring points. All four of the blockers from Texas fending her off, knocking her out to the outside and forcing her to recycle back, and but not terribly far.
Penalty whistle blows in the pack. But a low block penalty was assessed to attitude adjustment. Meanwhile, through the pack, another scoring pass for Crisis.
Ours is going to tell you that Haas, the boss, is back in.
Uh-huh. She is. So we have both jammers in play. Haas, the boss, getting knocked to the inside courtesy of Blackjack. And once again, Haas meeting up with Blackjack as the jam is going to be called. 4 points for Atlanta.
It looks like one for Texas, unless that thumb... Thumbs mean things.
But a 16-point jam right there for Atlanta. A nice jam for them. 63 points to Texas' 94. So Atlanta trying to get something started right here. It's the ATL chants fill the arena. ATL.
Like, what are they saying? The headphones don't help me know about the outside world.
Bazooka Bubble Bum is the Texas jammer. Hermione Danger jamming for the first time for Atlanta. Four-on penalty assessed.
Hermione is already passing that star off. So. Pivot baller shot caller who's taken, I believe, a couple of star passes in this game so far.
Bazooka Bubble Bum back in the pack looking for points now as lead jammer. Gonna call it off. Picks up, looks to be two. Two, yes, I'm correct on that, 2 points. 96-63 now in favor of Texas. Remember, the winner of this game moves on to face Dos Por Cuatro, who defeated Paris in our prior game. So that'll be a semifinal game. Taking place tomorrow at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And looks like we have, once again, Aphrodite wearing the star for Atlanta. Dardar Binks jamming for Texas. It looks like a multiplayer block assist in the pack to stone her. And once again, pack deciding to stay put in turn one because that's where they want to be.
It's where the cool kids are.
Apparently.
Why wouldn't you want to be there? Oh, someone's kneecap has come off. Or the cap to their knee pad, not their actual.
Gasket knee.
Don't get scared now.
Nobody's kneecap came off.
it's not their patella.
It's not like that. But that pack's still sitting tight there in turn 1-2. But Aphrodite finally put a breakthrough in her lead.
In the meantime, there has been a penalty assessed to Texas's pivot, Bo Jackson.
Well, Aphrodite now back into the fray looking for points, but big hitting going on in this pack. Dardar Binks took off the star cap, and I was trying to maneuver her way around that Atlanta defense. Once again, just setting up shop and stopping.
absolutely amazing braces.
Trying to push through now. Aphrodite taking a spill, but right back up on her wheels. Getting some help now from Blackjack, trying to free her up in the middle.
But even Blackjack's having a hard time. Right. That should tell you something.
Right.
And the reformation of this brace is almost immediate, so I don't envy Aphrodite right now.
I mean, both of these jammers are really having a tough time, but that, again, that's a credit to these teams' defenses.
Yeah, the star was in the hand, I thought, of Blackjack. It did get dropped and repurchased by Aphrodite.
Looks like a position penalty assessed at the end of that action against Texas, against Marisi Livin. Jam is over. 4-0 jam in favor of Atlanta.
Yeah. So such an amazing action-packed jam. Right. And just 4 points picked up by Atlanta. 0 picked up by Texas. So 96-67.
So we have a freight train versus a human missile crisis. This sounds like a disastrous jam. It's going to be really awesome. Peace War taking a spill after a bump from missile crisis. And a forearm penalty assessed. Oh, to human missile crisis on that contact. So we're going to have a power jam for Texas. Freight Train resetting at the pivot line, now trying to move her way through the pack. And Freight Train again with almost that signature pirouette toe stop dance to break through the pack and pick lead.
All right, we do have Crisis standing in the box, soon to re-enter play. The pack is hanging around. Turn two.
Freight Train says, I don't want to hang around with y'all anymore. I'm going away. Picking up my 4 points and just skating around.
BRB. All right. Crisis back in action. Does make quick time of that pack. Meantime, Freight Train is through for another scoring pass. Right now, Texas sitting right on that 100-point line. Has picked up another two, so we are at 102. Atlanta at 67 as we are nearly halfway through the second half.
Still a lot of time left to go in this game.
Still a lot of time.
And we're only heading into jam number 10 of our second half. So these jams have been pretty long and defensive. So, yeah.
It's entertaining to me to see the different strategies between these teams with the quick jams and then this, we're seeing much longer jams. I was going to say slow jams.
Slow jams.
You know, I will. Slow jams.
And it looks like lead jammer is going to go to troublemaker for Atlanta. Meanwhile, Bazooka Bubble Bum still fighting in the front of the pack, trying to get around Erica Barduzzi and Bala Shot Caller. Able to shed Bala to make her initial. And once again, a pack settled in turn two. And Troublemaker trying to push forward. And now it gets around the block of Stoneher. Oh, it gets a no pass, no penalty. There are 4 points.
Still worked out.
Still worked out, right? And, oh, and no pass, no penalty. 4 points now for Bazooka Bubble Bum. So nobody, 3 points, I'm sorry. No, they got the four.
It was all four, yeah.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not.
So. And now Troublemaker getting recycled all the way back to turn number two. It's nice blocking again up front by Erica Barduzzi and Bala Shot Caller, but wow. Bazooka Bubble Bum is spun around saying, I'm going to stay in bounds. Yeah. Go. And that's what she did.
This is what I want.
This is what I want to do, and I'm going to do it.
And she reached out and achieved her dreams.
So Jam has called 4 points additionally for Atlanta. 8-8 Jam. 110-75 is now your score in favor of Texas.
So in case you're curious about some penalties, because I haven't talked about that, I was very talkative about it earlier. Our penalties are fairly low in this game. Texas, in total, between the two periods, has picked up 15. Atlanta had picked up 22. It was earlier, like the first game of the day, there was like over 40 for one of the teams. So.
Right. Here we go, our next jam. Haas the Boss up against Aphrodite. And again, these defenses trying to just set up and not give any ground. Aphrodite up front trying to bust through that Texas wall of red. And meanwhile, Lee Jammer does break through, and it is Haas the Boss. And Haas now on a scoring pass. Was an outside lane, almost wide open, but not quite.
Ooh.
Nice block from Ziplock, but able to keep on rolling for 4 points.
So the star has been passed to Matitude Adjustment from Atlanta, but she's currently
rather occupied with Peace War.
Problems.
That's putting it lightly, because Peace War did not want to let her go.
She didn't want it.
Do not want. And Jam has called 4 more points for Tech.
And bring Texas up to 118. Atlanta's still sitting at 75. We are now about 13 minutes left in the game. And watch this replay of Haas absolutely ricocheting off of people as she comes through the pack and finally dodging that last block narrowly.
Very, very narrowly. And off we go. Human Missile Crisis jamming for Atlanta. Texas going to counter with Captain Sassy. Again, pack party in turn one.
Crisis just absolutely, like, you know, they're just moving laterally at this point. All four.
Side to side.
All four of Texas's blockers just following her back and forth, left to right.
But Captain Sassy recycled from the inside and just found the seam and took it all the way through and picked up Lee Jammer.
Now coming in for the first scoring pass. It looked like the star has been passed on Atlanta's side to Blackjack.
And looks like Captain Sassy now trying to fight around the outside. Trying to get around Erica Baduzzi. Does get around, picks up the 4 points. And Blackjack still trying to spin. Wow, nice spin move by Blackjack on the edge of that inside track. That's only her initial. As the jam is going to be called off, but not before four more points rung up for Texas. 8-0 jam gives them 126, Atlanta 75. And we have a team timeout, I believe.
Indeed.
Called by Atlanta.
That is what is happening.
So we also didn't really talk a lot about scoring at halftime. So we can look at some scoring and see who's doing right now.
That'd be super.
Looking at Texas, looks like total points now looks like Freight Train with 35. 33 for Hoss the Boss. Bazooka Bubble Bum, 31. Dardar Bink, 17. And really only other points were going to be Peace War picked up, I believe. No, she didn't get any on that pass, sorry. That's really all your scoring. Is the four jammers for Texas really picking up the majority of your scoring?
Absolutely. I mean, and something I'm always interested in is the lead percentages.
Yes.
And right now, when we started this half, I should point out, Bazooka Bubble Bum had 100% lead attained. She missed one and now down to 83%, but is, you know, the highest lead getter. For Texas and for Atlanta, that is going to be Human Missile Crisis, as you might have guessed, high in the rotation, and, you know, she sees a lot of action out there.
Also leading the way with 26 points for Atlanta is Human Missile Crisis. Aphrodite behind with 22, Troublemaker with 12. I also have Gucci Mane picking up 4, so that's your scoring for Atlanta. And we're back to skating here. Freight Train jamming up against Troublemaker.
It's going to be Freight Train picking up lead. I think there is potentially a star pass happening.
Possibly.
For Atlanta.
Yeah, for Atlanta. And then as it did happen, you called that one right on the dot. Looks like the star has been passed to Ball of Shot Caller.
And Star tried to hook it under a couple times without success.
Oh, Freight Train picking up a high block penalty. So she will take a seat in the penalty box. Power jam for Atlanta. Oh, not anymore, because a low block picked up by Ball of Shot Caller.
Oh.
So Freight Train will, the ejector seat in the penalty box will engage. And
that was
Freight
what
Train
my noises
in.
Were for.
Yes.
That's what, okay, just so we're clear, that was what I was watching right there. It looks very painful. But a very quick jammer switcheroo. Yeah. Both jammers back in play. Of course, that is going to make us not have any.
Yeah. So we're going to go the full 2 minute.
Yeah.
Yes. And we were going to still say intern number one here, apparently, again, because I like saying that. They just really like turn one.
You're real judgy about which turn they hang out
on. I mean, if you're sitting in turn one, you get a great view of this game. I mean, I'm not being judgy at all.
I feel like hopefully these are like VIP fans right here, and they're like really.
Or even if not, they've got a great view. But also, we also have our VIP section, our fan zone
over
here.
Our fan zone. I know that's the fan zone.
And it is quite full up over here on that backstretch. Penalty assessed to Texas, number 14, Cole Case to the penalty box.
This is a strange jam, I'm going to say that.
a big block there. Ball off balance for a second, but able to regain it.
Oh.
Ooh, Freight Train just took that block all the way around from Erica Baduzzi. But she did pick up a forearm for the contact. And jam is over. 4 more points for Atlanta.
So a lot going on in that one. And we finally saw Peace War trying to hold someone back and bring a friend in on it.
Yes.
Which is, you know.
Always bring a friend, you know.
Yeah.
You can't always bring a friend. Life's more fun.
Oh, that is a huge fall we're seeing on the replay right at
that
the end
was
where
a big,
it's
big
called.
Hit.
That was,
yes.
I'm going to call it severe.
Yeah, I think that is an accurate depiction.
That's the rating I would give it.
Here we go. Aphrodite jamming up against Bazooka Bubble Bum. Of course, Aphrodite for Atlanta in the white jerseys. Texas in the red.
And after all this time elapsed, they still have so much strength left in them. We're still seeing.
It is superhuman.
Yeah.
It really is. Like,
the same beautiful defense as we saw in Jam 1.
Right. And again, these jammers are both just getting mired behind the opposing defenses. Making progress through turn one now. Aphrodite still stuck in the back of the pack, trying to edge through the inside. But Bazooka Bubble Bomb trying to sled up against those front two blockers for Atlanta. nice clear out block by Marisi Livin. Freed her jammer up.
I believe this is lead. Okay.
She is lead jammer, yes.
All right. I was like, what happened?
Penalty assessed to attitude adjustment for Atlanta. So the Atlanta pivot in the box.
Mm-hmm. Aphrodite still trying so hard. And just Texas is not.
No, not at all. But same thing can be said up front. Atlanta is really trying to lock down on Bazooka Bubble Bomb, but she's able to find an outside groove and pick up the four-point pass.
Absolutely.
And again, just that stifling defensive work by both teams. But as we've seen, our star pass has been completed by Atlanta. Attitude adjustment came out of the box a second ago. Now is the jammer. And we close that jam out with an additional couple of points for Texas. Six-point jam in total.
Yeah, that's what I was going for. 6 points in total. We watched this replay, just this absolutely huge hits. And, of course, Texas jammer getting through. I would like to tell you a bit about the Pack-A-Seer special that we've got for Seattle.
Yeah.
You can get a four-pack of tickets for the 2019 International Playoffs in Seattle, Washington for $175. So you should check into that.
Yeah, that's a great deal.
It really is.
And we have a lead jammer going out here, Julia. It is Human Missile Crisis. And a penalty assessed to Hosta Boston. We're on a power jam as well now for Atlanta.
And they could use it.
Yes, right now that is a very, very welcome sight. As Crisis, jersey whip there around Blackjack to get around the corner in turn three. Does complete the pass, picks up 4 points. Atlanta trying to hold a goat in the back of the pack there now as Crisis trying to go through the front.
I thought she was going to zip on through, but... No. Texas found out about that plan.
Legal Knievel shut that one down on the inside.
Sure enough. Back in the action is, I believe, Hoss the Boss. For some reason, it says Peace War on the screen, but that is...
That is Hoss the Boss.
It is Hoss, isn't it? I recognize the Boss.
We're quite sure.
Yeah.
So we've been informed that we weren't actually aware of this. We did know, say, Dardar is, of course, a newer skater for Texas, but what we did not know is that she is a former skater for our host league as we begin Greensboro Roller Derby.
Nice. We were actually talking at half about where Dardar might be from, and so this is awesome to know.
But we definitely wanted...
Now they're taking that away from us, but we already have the information.
What has been seen cannot be unseen.
She gets double shout-outs.
Here we go. Freight Train jamming for Texas. Gucci Mane jamming for Atlanta. And Gucci Mane through on the outside of turn number one and his lead jammer. But Freight Train is lurking, coming around that corner.
The penalty box empties out. This is about as fast as the pack has gotten this game.
And Gucci Mane trying to call it off, but Freight Train still able to skip through for the full four-point pass.
Mm-hmm. So that was... 2 points picked up by Atlanta, or three points. I didn't see the thumb because it was away from me.
Now
4 points picked up by Texas, 140-90.
And we're about at 4 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the game. So we're about to get close to wrapping up our day one action here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And Bazooka Bubba Bama is the jammer for Texas. Aphrodite is the Atlanta jammer. Whistles blow in the pack. Oh, there you go. It's a four-on penalty, I believe, says to Atlanta. That's Wild Cherry.
That's going to be two of Atlanta's blockers currently in the box. One now standing and another one coming in. So there's three temporarily in the box, and followed by the jammer.
Not the jammer.
So now it's a party in the box.
The turn one party has moved to the penalty box.
You're super tired of this turn. We're going to take it over to the box. They've got chairs.
That was a track cutting call against Aphrodite. So we do have a power jam for Texas. And Bazooka Bubble Bomb is through for four. And the pack are waiting now at the pivot line. And nice block out there in the front. Blackjack doing work up there. Bazooka going to reset and try again. And once again, the stories of this game has been this wall work. I mean, just they set up shop and they don't want to give any quarter.
I mean, so Aphrodite being the second highest scoring jammer on Atlanta, every point is like so much work with these very thick, strong, almost indestructible walls.
4-point pass was completed by Bazooka Bubble Bum. And now looking for more as Aphrodite going to reset back by the pivot line. And through for another pass is Bazooka Bubble Bum. So now working on a 12-point jam. And she seems pretty content to just keep on going and run that timeout.
No reason not to. All right, that last pass picked up 2 points, so it's going to be a 14-point jam for Texas, bringing them up to 154. Atlanta is still at 90, and we are on an official timeout. And I want to finish where I very awkwardly started into a much longer than I meant to thing about the Seattle tickets. So you can get a 4-pack of tickets to the 2019 International Playoffs in Seattle, Washington for $175. That is $85 off the regular price. So if you're planning on joining us in Seattle, make sure you get your tickets today, and you can check that out by going to wftda.com/tickets.
That will be another fun event next weekend up in the Pacific Northwest.
It sure will.
Yes, it will. And then we will figure out what three teams from there will join the three teams from here. And the top four teams already have their spots at Champs in Montreal.
Much excitement.
Much excitement.
Derby Without Borders, again, is a charity project dedicated to removing the barriers to accessibility in the sport of roller derby. You can check out how you can get involved and what they've already accomplished at derbywithoutborders.org.
And I see Hoss the Boss with the star for Texas. I see Human Missile Crisis.
We see this as well.
For Atlanta. You do see this.
I can verify this.
And you know what? You all see it at home, too, because you have eyes and you're watching your screen.
Some people multitasking.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, nothing else. You heard us say it, so now you do know. And knowing is half the battle. Human Missile Crisis getting bumped around on the inside. Now going back to the outside trying to work. And another reset now. Hoss the Boss getting brought back to the jam line on the drawback. And it looks like Hoss trying to go outside but gets edged out of bounds. But able to keep going, I believe, and does pick up lead. So Hoss is the lead jammer. And it's like a direction of gameplay penalty assessed on the contact up in the front there. So it's Coco picking up that penalty.
So many things constantly happening.
Right.
A relentless jam. So Star was off, Star back on. It continues to be crisis jamming for Atlanta. She's now coming on her first scoring pass, but I'm thinking that no points were picked up. However, for Texas, 4 more points.
So we're going to wind down under a minute to go on the game clock. So we get maybe at least one in, but I hear whistles blowing now for a stoppage. Looks like we're going to have a official review being called by Atlanta, I believe. I say that with a question mark and an inflection in my voice, like I'm not quite sure.
You're right.
I am right. All right.
I see the blinky dot.
Yay! Blinky dot means I am correct.
Blinky dot would never betray us.
No.
I'd like to give a shout out to Meg Fenway, who is
Fenway
from home. Hey. just check Twitter really quick.
We do invite you. We've invited you all weekend. If you are watching at home, which you are, if you're listening to us, Go ahead and join in on the conversation. Use the hashtag TalkToWFTDA. We'd love to know what you're saying out there and what you're seeing and that you're enjoying watching our awesome playoff weekend here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina.
I'm especially excited this season.
Atlanta is requesting a cut penalty be issued to the Texas Jammer in the last jam.
So says Base Invaders. So we go.
Particularly excited to see how many times I'm going to accidentally talk over the head ref. No, how many watch parties have been going on?
Oh,
because,
I'm sure.
You know.
Well, I know Texas is having a big one in Austin tonight from what I've seen. I'm sure Atlanta's having one back home as well.
Sure.
I'm sure all of our teams here are having
great
watch parties.
I just love that's been getting me going this season because it's one of my favorite aspects of Derby. When you can't be there, at least, you know,
right,
be with your friends and watch it on a big screen and yell a lot.
Exactly.
It's fun.
You can be as loud as you want, and if you're loud enough, maybe we can hear you all the way over here.
It's not true.
I mean, I'm just trying to, you know.
I'm very far away from many people. Just realized I'm in a room full of them, but they're unlikely to watch. Anyways, you should check out adamskates.com for the latest in Derby gear. So I guess the jet lag's just now setting in.
took a whole day, but you know, it's all right.
I was feeling pretty good. Now I'm like, I might need a nap.
So we do know, as you said before, the winner of this game moves on to the semifinals to face Dos por Cuatro.
Yeah, that is going to be just an absolutely amazing game.
And, of course, the non-winner of this game will move into the consolation bracket area.
I also hope it would be an amazing game.
Oh, but these are all amazing
games.
What are you talking about?
I didn't mean to insinuate otherwise.
No, of course you did not. These are all awesome games. Of course, like I said, this is our final game of the day here on day one.
Further review. The officials have confirmed that the Texas Jammer, upon reentry, did not improve position. No cut call will be issued, and Atlanta will not retain their official review.
Thank you very much, Base Invader. That was my turn, so now we're even.
Trying to show me up.
Anything you can do, I can do better.
Oh!
Joking.
No, you can't.
Joking. Joking.
I'd like to vote for your best interruption. Anyways, this jam is upon us, very likely to be the final jam. That is Captain Sassy out for Texas and Gucci Mame for Atlanta. Who's got lead?
Captain Sassy.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like Gucci Mame going to take off a jammer cap and try to work through that pack. Penalty assessed to Texas. That was terabyte. Meanwhile, 4 points rung up by Captain Sassy.
It was an amazing final block and spin move as Gucci Mame finished off the pack. A wild call off from the floor, but what plot twist?
But she can't call it off because she got a penalty.
That was the plot twist.
Nope. There you go. Dun, dun, dun.
It was a back block being assessed. So this final jam will go the full length. We got just over a minute left there. So the period clock has gone down to zero.
So we are on jam time. You are correct. Yes.
Absolutely.
And Gucci Mame now in turn four. Leading, trying to stay in bounds, but can't quite do it. Going to have to reset. Going to go back behind. Looks like Peace War trying to draw her back. Way back.
Yeah, that's a...
Back to another zip code.
They want to go back to turn one. Oh, no.
I mean, it's the place to be, right?
You talked
about it.
So far. So really hard to do, but Captain Sassy is through. That is 4 points right now. Texas on this last jam at 8 points. We've got about 20 seconds left.
And it looks like Gucci Mame is through the pack, does get the 4 points. And a star pass by Texas now to Peace War.
All right. This might be Peace War's first time taking the
I think
star?
She took it earlier in the game.
Did she? Okay.
Yeah, she took a star pass earlier in the game. And jam comes to an end. One more point picked up by Texas. Two more by Atlanta. But Julius Leeser, we have an unofficial final score.
Woo! And that is Texas at 167, Atlanta at 96.
So when our score is made final, we will, of course, have one of our semifinal games set.
Well, what do we have to look forward to tomorrow morning, though?
Oh, tomorrow morning, bright and early. We are going to be here. I believe the first game is at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm sorry, I said 8:30. I apologize. No, it's p.m. 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Our first game will be Rainy City, the number 3 seed.
Nice.
Taking on Helsinki, who defeated Lom earlier today in the first round game. And followed by, at noon, will be the number 2 seed, Angel City. Mm-hmm. They will be taking on Bear City, who defeated Windy City earlier today. And then we move into, I believe, consolation action after that for a few games. And then we have our last two games of the day, which will be our two semifinals,
mm-hmm.
which will be, we know one of them right now, Dos Pacuatro will take on Texas. And, of course, we will figure out the other one tomorrow. And
yeah.
then they will play on Sunday to decide who finishes first and second. And then the third-place team also, the third-place game, those top three teams will move on to Montreal for champs.
So our score has been finalized. It is indeed Texas 167, Atlanta at 96. So thank you so much for joining us today.
It's been a great day one. We are going to be throwing down shortly to Def Mello, who's going to be doing our post-game interview. I believe she is ready or close to being ready, but if not, it's okay. We're going to watch our victory consolation laps.
She may be waiting for a victorious skater to join.
I believe so. Looks like she's going to be talking to Bazooka Bubblebum,
nice.
I believe. So that'll be a great interview. We look forward to it. Thank you so much for joining us here. We will see you again. We'll see you again tomorrow. So we will throw it down as soon as we can to Death Nella when she's available. And she was talking to Bazooka Bubblebum from the victorious Texas Roller Girls. So yeah, we will be doing that momentarily.
Oh.
All right.
And now we are throwing.
Now we are throwing. Here comes Death Nella with Bazooka Bubblebum.
Oh my goodness, what a great game. How are you feeling right now? I know, other than maybe a little nervous that I grabbed you over here for the interview, but we want to hear from you. That was a heck of a win. Through the quarterfinal, now into the semifinal. It's got to feel good.
It feels amazing. It's excellent. It's everything I wish for this season. I'm so glad to be here. It was amazing.
Okay, and speaking of this season in particular, you transferred from Dallas. This is your first season with Texas. So first postseason win. How was that adjustment with the new team and being embraced? I know Derby Twitter is lighting up with your name as well.
Oh. Dallas was great. They taught me a lot. It was a good foundation for where I am now. Being with Texas, they've welcomed me with open arms. They are a great bunch of ladies, and I love working with them. They're great.
And what exactly from that Dallas experience are you taking and bringing into this experience now with Texas Roller Girls?
Dallas, a lot of time I sat on the bench watching some of these really great jammers, and they drug me along to every tournament, and so I'm very grateful to get all that upper level experience with them because it really prepared me for today.
Oh, wait, are you saying you learned while being on the bench? What?
Yes, of course, yes. Get angry, get hungry. You watch all these other great jammers, you pick up their tricks and stuff, so yeah.
You've been doing so great. We have one more question. So we spoke with Dos Por Cuatro after their win last game. They're who you're facing tomorrow. And we asked them which team would they want to face, right, in the semifinal. And they honestly said both you and Atlanta are their idols. So we want to know, who do you look up to, whether it's a team or a skater from the past or right now, who are you looking up to for inspiration on the track?
I don't really fangirl very much, but honestly, I look up to all my teammates because I've been watching them for years. So every one of my teammates, they offer something to me. So I look up to every one of them.
Well, we wish you all the best as you move forward now into the semifinals that's happening tomorrow, day 2, right here in Winston-Salem. Now let's go back to the desk.